The ayes to the right, 322. The noes to the left, 306.
Debacle and defeat in the Commons means Boris Johnson is compelled to do what he said he wouldn't, ask for a Brexit delay. He sent the letter, but defiantly added a covering note and another letter. Boris Johnson didn't sign the first letter to Donald Tusk, copied straight from the so-called Benn Act. It's a simple extension request, noting if the parties are able to ratify before this date, the government proposes that the period should be terminated early.
I think the most significant thing is that he sent it. The fact that he hasn't signed it and the fact that he sent a kind of side letter is clearly his way of trying to communicate, well, I didn't want to send it, I was made to send it.
This covering note accompanied the first letter sent from the UK's ambassador to the EU, explaining Her Majesty's government will introduce the necessary legislation next week in order to proceed with ratification of the withdrawal agreement. What's been more controversial is this second letter, signed by Mr Johnson to all EU leaders. He writes any delay would be corrosive, adding, I've made clear since becoming Prime Minister and made clear to Parliament again today my view and the government's position that a further extension would damage the interests of the UK and our EU partners and the relationship between us.
The content of the letter, it doesn't directly contradict the first letter because it was clear that if he did that, he might be in breach of the law. So in effect, what it says is no surprises. It's what he's been saying to the European partners, you know, over recent weeks, that he wants to get this done by the 31st if he can.
The Scottish courts will consider whether the Prime Minister has acted illegally. The Shadow Chancellor among those raising concerns.
He may well be in contempt of Parliament or the courts themselves because he's clearly trying to undermine the first letter and not signing the letter. He's behaving a bit like a sport brat.
The letters are now in the hands of the EU.
Is the EU going to be open to an extension? You've had the request now.
The President Tusk will consult in the next days.
Brussels won't be rushed into responding, preferring to see how things play out in Parliament this week. Laura Bundock, Sky News.